Greetsy YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent.
In video number 101, I showed a principle on how to save energy for extremely low power devices using a mechanical switch. This principle is necessary if your device uses any sensors or circuitry other than the ESP itself. I used an IFTTT Dash Button as a simple example to show the principle. Since then, many viewers asked about the Dash Button itself. So, today I will finish this button using another low power principle of the ESP. Let's start. In video 101, I used a FET transistor to switch the power of the whole device more or less completely off during non-activity. This is a safe method, but if you only have an ESP and nothing else, like in the IFTTT button, you do not need this extra transistor. You can do it with an ESP alone. And in addition, I suggested to use an ESP8285 because of its small size. In the meantime, I remembered my few ESP01s from the early days of ESP8266, collecting dust because they only have one or two usable I/O pins and small memories. For this scenario, they are ideal and for me free of charge. But how can we conserve energy without an additional FET? I made already a few videos concerning deep sleep. If you are interested, you can also watch these. The German journal CT, in its last issue, makes a proposal. Use this deep sleep state of the ESP for such a button. The ESP always keeps powered on. This is different to the concept of video number 101. To start the send, they switch the reset pin with a mechanical switch to low and back to high. So, the ESP is started and does its thing to send a message. They use GPIO2 with an LED to signal success or failure. At the end, they set the ESP in deep sleep with the command ESP.deepsleep0. Let's now quickly consult the data sheet. Really, during deep sleep, the ESP8266 should only use 10 microampere. So I quickly set up a scenario with an old ESP01. And of course, I used Dave Jones' microcurrent gold to get an exact measurement of the current in deep sleep. You see, the module uses about 400 microampere during deep sleep, which is much more than the 10 microampere promised in the datasheet. But looking at the board, we see the reason for that current, the red power LED. If you remove it using a solder iron, the deep sleep current goes down to 15 microampere, which is close to specs. Now we can do a short calculation. If we use this LiFePO4 battery with a capacity of 700 milliampere hour or 700,000 microampere hours, we see that the dash button should run 700,000 microampere hours divided by 20. Equals 35,000 hours divided by 24 for a day equals 1458 days divided by 365 equals roughly 4 years without pressing the button and without considering the self-discharge of the battery. This is okay for me. So the power problem is solved. The diagram looks now like that. We connect the chip enable to VCC and the reset pin via a 10 kilo ohm pull-up resistor also to VCC. The button is connected between reset and ground. The LED in the button is connected to GPIO2 and of course we add a current limiting resistor of a few hundred ohms. A viewer sent me this link. Here they try to build a low power ESP connected to a PIR sensor. And a little later, also with only a button. Instead of deep sleep and the reset pin, it uses the chip enable pin to reduce power consumption of the ESP. Let's first check how much current the ESP uses with chip enable low. After removing all unnecessary parts, The current with chip-enabled low is also around 10 microampere. But unfortunately, with the proposed diagram of this web page, I was only able to measure 1.2 milliampere, which is 100 times more. I did not find out why. Maybe a viewer knows more about this phenomenon. So I stick with the first concept. Now let's continue with a sketch. Fortunately, after the last video, one of my viewers created a neat little IFTTT library which even uses HTTPS. So we can directly call IFTTT. Great! Now we just have to enter the credentials of our channel and also add up to 3 values if we want. And the whole thing chooches, as ABE would say. Just a small remark, the channel description is case sensitive. It took me quite a long time to find this out. At the end, the LED blinks if successful and the ESP goes to deep sleep. But this thing is not yet finished. Of course, I would have liked to put this app to iotappstory.com. But because the first ESP-01s only had 512 kilo flash, they cannot be used for OTA. So the sketch is written the conventional way with credentials hard-coded. Because I will use several of these buttons, for example, also to switch my camera LED lamp in the lab, I milled a small PCB. Then I soldered the ESP-01, the button and the resistors to this PCB. Of course, I added also a decent capacitor. As a last step, I printed a small box. In the base of the box, I hot glued battery contacts from another battery holder. I use a LiFePO4 battery to power the thing. If you do not know why this is ideal, watch my videos about battery types for small devices. The first version of the box did not work. Everything worked fine until I put the ESP in the box. Once in the box, it did not work anymore. First, I thought it loses electrical contact in this small box. But finally, I discovered that always out of the box it worked, in the box it did not work. This shows us another lesson about radio frequencies. If the antenna somehow is close to metallic surfaces, it is influenced by them. What means close? The higher the frequencies, the shorter the wavelength, and also the shorter the antennas. The ESP has already a pretty small antenna, but if metal and batteries consist of metal is closer than the size of the antenna, you can expect trouble. This is why I had to enlarge the box a little, and now it works also in the box. And here it is, the IFTTT Dash Button. If I press the button, the LED shows with a small blink that the sketch works. After a while, the LED flags success. And a little later, the mail from IFTTT arrives in the mailbox. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, please like. Bye!